Hello, everyone, and welcome to this FDI Insights series on Botswana, produced in association with the Botswana Investment and Trade Center, or BITC. I am joined today by Mr. Keletsositse Olebile, the CEO of the Botswana Investment and Trade Center itself. Mr. Olebile, can you please give us an introduction to your institution?
Botswana Investment and Trade Center is the lead agency of the government of Botswana, tasked with a couple of mandate lines. At the core of our mandate is to promote and facilitate investment into Botswana. We look at a couple of lines in that regard. We attract and promote foreign direct investment, that is investment emanating from funds that come from outside Botswana. We do look for these investors in select sectors, facilitate them to settle in the country, and then look after them on an ongoing basis to make sure that they can settle in and reinvest their earnings in the country. We look at the line of domestic investment, which is investment from sources that originate within the country. There are lots of sources of funds within Botswana, so we facilitate those as well to deploy. We look at export development and promotion. That is, once the investors are on the ground in Botswana, we help them, because Botswana has a small market in terms of the population size. We would help these investors to then deploy and sell their products in other surrounding markets, and government uses bilateral, multilateral trade agreements to do that. But most importantly, we also have the mandate of running what we call nation branding, or Brand Botswana. Brand Botswana being a unit that aims at ramping up global awareness about what Botswana stands for. Because as you know, Botswana as a country is amongst the rest of Africa, which is oftentimes looked at in very interesting ways. So Botswana being maybe the outlier within Africa, it's our responsibility to make sure that we differentiate what this country stands for and how it can enable the rest of Africa to attract investment through Botswana. As part of our mandate, we run the Botswana One-Stop Business Services Center. So anybody that's looking at doing business in Botswana and needs any kind of government authorization in order to deploy, we are the people to go to, and then we will facilitate you across the broad government system.
The International Monetary Fund expects the economy of Botswana to bounce back and grow by 8.7% in 2021. What will be the role of foreign investment in this post-COVID recovery phase?
You know what? Most of the economic benefits that you can talk about emanate from investment. It is through investment that you get companies forming. It is through investment that you get jobs created. And I think that's the aspect that Botswana needs more than anything, job creation, particularly for our youth. It is through investment that we facilitate the transfer of skills from these incoming companies to our people. It is also through investment that we deepen the sophistication of our financial markets as the funds flow through Botswana, through our financial system, into whatever markets that we are looking at. So I think that is the role that as BITC we will be playing, to make sure that investors come in, they create these opportunities for Botswana, and in the end, this culminates into positive economic growth.
How has the country's investment proposition been evolving in the wake of the pandemic?
The pandemic caught everybody unaware, but I think there are some positives that we can derive out of the pandemic, because this was a moment where, while we were suffering lockdowns and difficulties for international travel, countries must utilize this to reposition themselves, to look at aspects of ease of doing business, to make sure that when we emerge on the other side, we are more on a positive light. I think in Botswana, all the necessary responses were put in place to minimize the impact. We have the economic response plan that included things like wage subsidies to companies so that we can preserve the most important jobs. But more than that, we even have a further plan that we will be implementing as a country post-COVID to make sure that we can accelerate the recovery. But what I like the most is that despite the advent of COVID, we somehow managed to still stay afloat, using particularly technology to still engage some of the markets that we are targeting. We've run a lot of webinars and seminars online that were well attended. And out of those, it's interesting that we see some investments still deploying. I can just share some numbers here that in the 4 months between December up to March, December 2020 up to March 2021, SBITC would be expecting job creation of around 4,050 jobs out of the advanced projects that we've successfully managed to convert during the COVID era. So that really says, I think we're doing a lot of the right things to make sure that we minimize the impact of the pandemic.
What will be the role of the Botswana Investment and Trade Center in supporting the country's economic recovery?
When you talk about the facilitation of investment, the facilitation of Botswana products into export markets, the extension of, you know, the positive image of Botswana and projecting it to the world, you are talking BITC.
Thank you, Mr. Olebile. And thanks everyone for watching. If you want to know more about Botswana, follow our Insights series on FDIintelligence.com.